Colonel Grijaldo, isa ka sa mga pinapatawag doon sa hearing sa Quadcom.
Yes, Sir Honor.
Well, pwede mong i-share kung anong gusto mong i-share dito sa committee na ito?
Yes, Sir Honor. Mr. Chair, Your Honors, sa ating lahat, magandang hapon. Allow me to read my opening statement. Matapos ang House Quadcom hearing na umabot ng 14 hours, dumating ako sa bahay ng madaling araw ng October 23, kasagsagan ng bagyong Christine. Hinihintay ako ng aking pamilya at nag-aalala at di nakatulog hanggang safety akong makauwi. Dala-dala ko ang masamang karanasan at hinanakit sa pangyayari, pero di ko agad nasabi sa aking asawa. Hanggang lumipas ang ilang araw, napansin niyang matamlay at di ako mapakali. Di ko sabihin sa kanya, kahit alam kong apektado siya at may nervyos pag ang pag-usapan ay tungkol sa trabaho ko. With great courage, I confided everything to her. Kahit ito ay malaking problema, and it will affect us, and it will change on our normal and simple life. My career for almost 30 years of service, our personal and family safety and security, and maybe I will be condemned or be ostracized. My wife hugged me and started to cry and asked me why. I told her patagal na tayong nagsusumikap and we have to be strong and survive together. Mauna ni ang panahon nga magpakabanata means makialam. Lisod maging witness rata o maging innocent bystander. Maangol gyapon ta o maging casualty tayo. Gipasabot na ko sa iyaha. I have to explain to her. Kailangan naay mo barog sa kamatuoran. There must be someone to rise up to the occasion. I told her that I have the moral obligation and a call of duty to uphold as police officer. In the eyes of God and in the soul of man, I have to say this, even God was betrayed 3 times. But this time, I have to say this, I don't want to betray our beloved country, our fellow Filipinos, and to God Almighty. I don't want to discredit the men and women of the Philippine National Police, the institution where I belong. I don't want to destroy my beloved alma mater, the Philippine National Police Academy, who molded me with moral values to speak for the truth that I owe, and it's time to give it back the honor and respect. Your Honor, allow me to read my affidavit.
Good. See?
David?
Yes, Sir Honor.
Also submit a copy to us.
Sige, yes, Sir Honor.
Mahaba po yan? Ilang pages pa yan?
Saglit lang, Your Honor.
Go ahead. Okay.
Allow me to read your orders, my affidavit. I, Police Colonel Hector U. Grijaldo, third level officer, presently assigned a personal holding administrative unit, Kamkrami, Quezon City, after duly sworn to, under oath and in accordance with law, do hereby depose and states that I've been dedicated to public service for almost 30 years, and since I took my oath as cadet on June 1, 1995. On October 16, 2024, I was again invited as a resource person in the 9th Joint Public Hearing of Committees on Dangerous Drug, Public Order, Safety and Human Rights, and Public Accounts of the House of Representatives scheduled on October 22, 2024 at 9:30 a.m. I, together with other invited PNP personnel, attended the joint hearing in the House of Representatives. After I answered questions related to extrajudicial killings and the reward system, I was approached by a security personnel while I was seated in one of the witnesses during the hearing. The said person told me that I was summoned by Congressman Dan Fernandez. I went out of the room with the security personnel. When we were outside, he told me to go to the left corridor and proceed straight to the end room. While walking, I saw other witnesses who were standing in the corridor, including my classmate, Major Portalesa, and Captain Anova, who was wearing a PMP uniform, and the latter acknowledged me by saluting. When I entered the room, I saw two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma standing inside the room. One of the lawyers approached me and then asked me what we are going to talk about. I said, I do not know. After a while, Kong Dan Fernandez entered the room and he asked me to sit beside him on his right side. And then Kong Abante entered the room, sat far end of the chair on the right. One of the lawyers of Police Karma stood near at my back. Kong Dan Fernandez put the paper he was holding on the table and told me, ito ang sasabihin mong statement na ito, while pointing on the paragraph on the paper. Ito ang supplemental affidavit ni Colonel Garma. Sabihin mo, alam mo ang reward system. I-confirm mo lang. Kong Dan told me to read the said affidavit. However, I asked the copy of affidavit he was showing to me to read it. He did not give it to me. The lawyer of Police Colonel Garma said, ikaw lang ang pwedeng magsabi niyan, sabi ni Colonel Garma. I was puzzled and I asked myself, why me? I respectfully told him that I cannot confirm. They are saying as I have not read the affidavit. We went silent for a while. And then Kong Dan Fernandez said, while holding the affidavit, saan ka pwede? Dito, noong 1999, about DDS, alam mo to, pulis ka na sa Davao nito. I politely told him that I was not still with the PNP because I was working with the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology in 1999 that time. After some time, Kong Abante asked me how many years do still I have with the PNP. I answered, I still have 4 years before my retirement. Then he made a remark, pwede ka pang maging general. I humbly responded to him, masaya na ako sa ranggo ko, sir. Pagkatapos nito, sir, uuwi na lang ako. At magtatanim na lang ako ng kamote sa amin. The cordial conversation between us continued. And I felt that they wanted me to convince me to do what they wanted me to do. Then Kong Abanti asked me where I serve as a chief of police. To which I answered, Mandaluyong City Police Station, sir. Kong Abanti then persuaded me by saying, ikaw naman, Colonel, ganito na lang. Alangan namang walang insidente o pangyayari sa panahon na yon. I answered, and I served as a COP in Mandaluyong during the COVID-19 pandemic. And there were less crime committed. And we did not receive any reward from anyone. I added that we only received funds, additional MOA or support fund, from the Peace and Order Fund of the LGU. I then respectfully told Kong Dan Fernandez that anybody can debunk my statement. If I confirm the testimony of Colonel Garma about the DDS in 1999, since I was not a member of PNP at the time. And I have no personal knowledge as to the reward system. Additionally, I said, the work of the policemen are noble and requires great sacrifice, even without the reward or award. It is our moral obligation and a call of duty to serve our country and people. Then Kong Dan asked me, si Colonel Garma, anong masabi mo sa kanya sa Barayuga? I politely told him, I cannot comment on the case. When I respectfully answered him, sir, mahirap yan. Kasama kami sa nag-iimbestiga at hindi ko alam kung anong kinalaman niya at may imbestigasyon din sa amin, baka ma-incriminate ako, sir. After the discussion, they did not give me a copy of the second affidavit of Police Colonel Garma. I felt that I disappointed them. Kong Dan Fernandez and Kong Abanti left the room, while I and the two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma stayed in the room for a while. I presume that they are about to present the second affidavit of Police Colonel Garma. I asked the two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma why they have chosen me. They did not answer me and just stared at me. And that I went back to the hearing room. When I went back to the hearing room, I immediately called the attention of Police Colonel Lito Patay, who were sitting behind the witness table. We proceeded at the back of the lobby area when they suspended the hearing. I confided and discussed to him what happened in the room with Kong Dan Fernandez and Kong Abanti and the two lawyers of Police Colonel Garma. That's all, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Colonel Grijaldo. What motivated you to speak before this committee?
The time, Your Honor, I was insulted, and it is very offensive, and I think it is inappropriate for anyone to act like that.
Meaning, you feel that you are being coached to make that statement?
Yes, Your Honor. I feel I've been corrupted to make that statement, Your Honor. But just because that time, habang nag-uusap-usap, habang nagkakaroon ng deliberation doon sa hearing, Your Honor, hindi ko alam kung may ipipresent nila si Colonel Garman at that time, Your Honor, na mag-ano nung second supplemental, ay yung supplemental affidavit niya.
So, do you feel harassed? Did you feel harassed?
It's an harassment and very offensive, Your Honor, and uncalled for anybody. At that time, I was wearing my uniform.
You're wearing your uniform?
As police officer.
And you are being told to lie?
Parang am I correct? Gusto nilang magsisinungaling po ako, Your Honor.
So, Colonel Grijaldo, I would like to thank you for your courage. I'm sure maraming police ngayon nanonood. And if you have observed, mabuti na nagsalita ka. Dahil if you have observed, the way they are treating policemen in the Quadcom, it's very hard. I feel them. Because naging police din ako. Kapag sasabihan ka lang, answer yes or no. You can only answer yes or no. You're not allowed to explain yourself. So, para bang you are being deprived. You are being deprived of your right to explain yourself. Kaya, lalong-lalo na kapag ikaw itinuturuan na itong sasabihin mo, itong paragraph sasabihin mo, o dito, pwede ka ba dito? So, that's very inappropriate and it's very irregular for a lawmaker making an investigation in aid of legislation to make that kind of approach to a resource person na parang pinipilit na itong sabihin mo, iku-coach ka, ito, pwede ka ba dito? Para parang lumalabas na meron talaga silang preconceived na goal na kung anong dapat lang ma-hit dito, kaya ginaguide yung magiging statement mo. Am I correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So ngayon, Mr. Chairman, kung nakikinig yun ang Philippine National Police, lalong-lalo na yung liderato ng Philippine National Police, I don't know what's his reaction with the statement of Grijaldo, because Colonel Grijaldo is just, I congratulate him for being so courageous enough to speak up for the truth in behalf of all the policemen na parang winawalang hiya sa mga tao na dapat hindi magwalang hiya sa inyo. Ay, kung nakikinig yun ang CPNP, I hope this is your person, this is your man. Dapat dipinsahan ninyo ito. Huwag ninyo itong ilagay sa litsunan. Huwag nyo ilitsun itong tao na ito. Because he's standing for the PNP. Na dapat hindi ganun ang treatment ng mga resource person pagdating sa investigation. Kasi parang ang baba ng tingin ng sa inyo, ng nag-iimbestiga sa inyo. Yun lang ang nakikita ko. Masyadong mababa. That's all, Mr. Chairman.
Thank
congratulations.
You,
and we'd like to thank you for standing up.
Your time has also expired. But sige, and the long and short of it, yung may kling kwento, kasi hindi ko naman napanood buong Quadcom, ano eh. Kayo ba ay tumistigo sa Quadcom din, finally? Nagsalita rin kayo ron?
Yes, sir. We were already at the...
Nag-affidavit ka doon? Nag-submit
ka sa... Wala po kaming in-affidavit ko just sa...
So, ilang tanong lang ang sinagot mo doon? Ilang tanong? Tungkol saan? Anong topic?
The last time that I was... asked by Congressman Paduano, it's all about the operation sa Oron, Your Honor.
Oron? One particular operation?
Yeah.
It's sa first appearance mo? Second appearance mo?
Ano, Your Honor, the first appearance on September 27, it's all about about EGK that time, Your Honor.
Sige, basta wala kang affidavit, so makikita na natin. Okay, so... my colleagues, no, the president is getting tired. So kung meron tayong questions for the address to the former president, tanungin na lang natin. Sir, okay ka lang, sir?
Sir, I'm good until 4 o'clock.
Yeah, I know.
So, 5 na, sir. 5 na.
Totoo, sir.
4 a.m.
Ah, 4 a.m.
Hindi ako nagpapatawa.
Yes, no. I know. I know that, Mr. President.
Mr. Chairman, okay, so, just to clarify, and then I hope I didn't miss anything. When Colonel Grijaldo made mention about him being asked to lie and being asked to be influenced by a legislator. He is by himself, Mr. President.
There's
no one in the room who can
witness.
Actually,
sino daw naka-witness ng exchange na yun?
Anyone, sir?
At present the time, the two lawyers of Colonel Garma, there were on the right side of Tabak that time, Your Honor, because it was discussed in the table on this place, and it was shown to them also. It can be seen by the two lawyers, because we are only five in the room, Your Honor.
And seen and heard
the
words that you uttered a while ago.
Just because one of the lawyer reacted when I refused to confirm the statement, because the holdings of this paper, Your Honor, like this, it was on the second page, and I've seen some notes or names, and my name was indicated in that statement. I rejected, or I don't want to say rejected, parang nag-explain na ako na hindi ko kayang i-confirm yung statement na yun.
And what was the reaction again? The reaction of the lawyer said?
Hindi na rin sila umimik, Your Honor. Okay. Kasi yun lang naman gusto nila na mag-collaborate doon sa statement na pinabit ni Colonel Garma.
Thank you, Mr.
Okay,
Chair.
So can we now entertain questions directed to the former president? Oh, no, sir. You're right. Take a wait a minute.
Yes,
the president raising his hand. Yes, sir.
Thank you for giving me the time. I'd like to ask the Colonel, sino yung idiot na superior mo?
What is the question, sir? That who is the superior of?
Yes, the one who. Alam mo ano ang ginawa nung ulol na yon? Subornation of perjury. That is a crime. Tingnan mo sa revised penal code. Subornation.
Kipo, I think you already stated it, ano? Kaya Colonel Grijaldo. Nasagot na po niya, Mr. President. Nasa testimony na po niya. Sige po, can we now proceed? Who has questions for the former president?
Mr. Chair, I'd like to make it clear na yung ginawa ng idioto na opisyal mo o classmate mo.
Sir, it's not officer, congressman. Congressman ang nagsabi sa kanya. Congressman.
Yung idioto na congressman, subornation o perjury yan. He was suggesting the mere suggestion of what he wants you to do is already a crime under the revised penal code. Yung inuudyok mo yung tao na mag-execute ng affidavit falsely or making a false narrative. Subornation of perjury.
Yes, that's a crime under the revised penal code.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Nang habulin yung classmate mo? Ayong congressman? Parang papailan ko ng kaso. Total, hindi ko na kailangan yung affidavit mo. Your narrative here is under oath. Hindi ko na kailangan yung affidavit mo. All I have to do is to take out your statement the basis of filing a case of
subornation. Our transcript of records will be available to anyone who will request, Mr. President.